Hello, fellow weirdos. Welcome back to Peek Over My Shoulder in Cradle. Last night I made some progress. Pretty good progress, actually. Yeah, but then, as I played on, I pushed the wrong button and I failed to record it. So right now I'm gonna replay some. But because I already know what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pick some stuff with me. Wait a minute. I used to have the sword in my inventory. Why do I have it no longer? It seems that when you reload, then all your stuff resets to some some default state. Yeah, also my door was opened yesterday. It was more open than this. Yeah, okay. Oh wait, let's talk to her before we go and talk to the other guy. No. Wait a minute. Did we put in the breeder unit? Yes, we did. Okay, that means we can't talk to her just yet. Okay, then. Going. Woohoo! Hello. Yo.
Well, where'd you disappear to? Listen, I found out how much they're paying. It's good money. Very good, actually. I'm going tomorrow. The procedure is simple. No pain and almost no damage. Sure, your brain is a little worse for wear while the patient recovers, but a job's a job, right? I might even quit the whole flower collecting business. But all that's still just castles in the sky. In the meantime, we've got title copies to sell. I got an order for you, so listen up. 2 red, 70 at the least. 1 orange.
Yeah.
Sorry, I don't know what that means. Who are you?
And a bitch. I ain't got time to spare, so why are you wasting it? The Baja is gonna get fired. I don't want to go back to getting shut down for 20 days in a month span.
I lost my memory, Baja. What are Fido copies?
If this is a joke, it's a real dumb one.
What do we have here?
Tell me what Fido copies are, and why we sell them.
Cut the crap. What do you mean, why sell them? Because people buy them. HQ goods are valuable. Somebody beautiful can license a copy of their DNA and sell it, which can then be used to make all sorts of stuff. Androids, flower vases, like the one on your table. As for you and I, we digitize flowers, make them into final copies and sell them. Understand? People like seeing a high number on the display. Beautiful things are always valued.
Why don't you collect the flowers yourself?
Are you mocking me? I've had enough of that. My head still ain't right after the last time. You're the weirdo around here. Strolling right alongside the enclosure without any harm. I'm just an old miserable outsider. Pretty damn useless, too. Then again, I'll be healing beautiful folks soon. Guess there's some use left in me yet.
Heal them from what?
I told you. Their emotions are all gone. They walk around like zombies, blinking vacantly. Treatment is in full swing. Donors are needed.
Donors of what?
What else? Immunity. Turns out the elite are more susceptible to panic. Some kind of burnout in their heads. So that's what happened. Emotional burnout in all the beautiful folk. Now they need their immunity to panic restored. But that immunity needs to come from somewhere, right? And who is it that endures panic best? Who are you going to turn to?
Yeah?
I don't know. The uglies?
Bingo. But see, nearly all the uglies have been put to sleep, so now they're being woken up.
Right, so before I go on with the dialogue, here are some conspiracy theories that I developed. So, point one, with all this ridiculous disguise, I've been wondering if this dude is actually the same dude as we are, just a different copy, maybe? Also, when we go back to speak with Ida, she will have some information that will further that will feed further conspiracy theories. Also, okay, so this dude has all I've been wondering if the names of our guys might be meaningful somehow. So maybe there's like a bilingual bonus here. I might have to look into it between episodes. So, actually, let me write this down for me. So this dude is called Dabaha. Our dude is called Enevish. And now I'm gonna look up if there's any hidden meaning there, because I'm pretty sure that this dude is not just a random merchant who just does business with you. I think this whole little ecosystem here has something else going on.
Fine, Bob. So, want me to pick some flowers?
No, dammit, not pick some flowers. If you go and pick the first flowers you see, feel free to stuff them right up your nostrils. Who's gonna buy those? What I need is the prettiest flowers you can find.
I'm not really an expert on aesthetics.
Amazingly, today you're even weirder than usual. Look, you take the gym, go up to the flowers and measure.
Swoosh. There he goes. Okay, because I came prepared, I'm going to carry on straight to the,
number on the chest is a personal heredity
flower fields. Yay! Okay, and because I already know how to do it, it should go pretty fast. Whoa! Okay, I think the numbers are random. Ah, bugger. Okay, we'll take this. Me managing an inventory and all. Didn't I have one over 90? I'm gonna get one really pretty. I mean, really high number. Measure a few more just in case. Oh, so I can. So if I interrupt the process, I'm gonna get a higher number. Interesting. Okay, let's go get a yellow one as well. I don't know if the flowers are random or not. Okay, not gonna pick up any sticks, not now. Whee! Whoa. Yes, that will do. And while we're here, oh, I don't have the sword thingy, so I won't go in the dome, I guess. I wanted to go and retrieve my sword, but if the vortex is here, I think I will lose my inventory, maybe. But maybe I can run past it. Let's try. So this is the toxin, supposedly. If I'm not mistaken, the fiery sword returns to a specific place between reloads, so I should be finding it by the pool. Somewhere here. Ah, yeah, here it is. So I don't know what's up with these residual noises. It's like digital echoes of people who have once been. Or maybe this is from our memory, I don't know. Let me show you something. So these interesting flowers here. No. Pick it up. See, it can't read them. Can I pick them though? No, not yet. Okay. Let's take the sword and let's banish some nasties. Ho ho! Sword. Any more vortices? There you go. I will happily banish them because I think you get an achievement for those. Whoosh. Oof. I mean, I don't know how the counting works between reloads, but still. We left our ride up there, we're gonna have to walk back or run. This looks like something could be buried here. Like overall, theoretically. didn't I prop a solar panel up there? Hello. It's nowhere to be seen. So it seems that certain objects reset when... Oh, the solar panel is over there, okay. Yeah, it seems that certain objects reset when you reload the game, which is a bummer. Show me the new tools! Yeah. Oh, I have to put it away first. Okay, open up. Now take it out. Easy peasy. Aww. The inventory looks really nice. Yoink. Talk to her yet? Okay, we have to close the box. Hey!
You know, I was thinking.
Mm-hmm.
I can ask the Baja to help with the evacuation.
No, Anovich. That's a bad idea. Until I've checked the number of my neurocopy, nobody must know about it.
Why is that number so important?
Because I'm not sure of my authenticity. We don't know where my neurochip was before making its way to me. If I'm a duplicate, then I'll simply be arrested at the first registration.
Well, all right. It's your call. So, let's check your number.
Nothing on that front either. I found a list of the amusement parks and police, but for some reason, my name isn't on it. I'm sure I used to work here. I need more particulars about anything more. My memories are fragmented and don't tell me anything.
But you remembered something, yes? Tell me.
Well, I remember that all kids would undergo a transfer after the show. I don't know why.
Undergo a what?
A mirror transfer. That's what the procedure of transferring consciousness into a mechanical body is called. Meaning, the kids would leave the mirror body and analyze. Strange, isn't it? Doing a transfer in an amusement park.
Strange is the word.
And another thing, their age. These kids were really young, around 5 or 6 at the most.
This brings up the second bit of my conspiracy theory. Our dude sounds kinda young, so I'm wondering if he might have been one of these kids.
What's odd about their age?
They were way too young for a transfer. Little kids don't get their lives replaced, but they did here for whatever reason. And I played some kind of role. Only I don't remember what it was.
Maybe you'll remember more once your sight is back.
Maybe. If Tobacco makes good on his promise, and if there's a functioning book screen in the park.
Tell me more about this.
let's ask other questions before we go.
Hope you understand something.
What?
You said these were 5-year-old kids, right?
I don't remember their exact age, but they looked no older than 5, maybe 6.
And their new bodies, were they similarly small?
No. Nobody even manufactured children's antibodies. There were only 2 standard models, adult and teenager. Children were transferred into teenage bodies. When leaving the prepared garden, they would join 15.
Which sounds about the age of our voice, I would say.
Not the coziest garden imaginable.
Okay, and this is as far as I got yesterday. Let's keep asking questions still.
Why is it illegal to transfer children?
I'm not sure. I think that it has to do with the nervous system, its development. Doing a transfer before it's fully formed is dangerous.
Got it.
And let's ask
Can you
some more.
Help me understand something.
What?
Whose eyes are on your lip screen?
Mine. The same eyes I was born with. The same shape and proportions. Everything is stored in the genome chip, my entire DNA.
Got it.
What if I say we didn't bring what you ask?
Not yet.
Oh, okay. It's just an answer. So, now that we are going out, let's just deliver these. And before we go into the flower dome once more, I'm gonna break the episode because I think we're gonna have to play some more cube games and I'm not a fan of those. So I'm gonna give those a new episode. But first, we need to deliver. The old dude, if he really is old. He said something about 3 hours, but I don't really know how time passes here. Should we wait? Should we do something else? Here's an idea. I want to put this here, and I'm gonna go back to the yurt for a thing. Here's something I tried last night. Get a new dream. sure if I've seen this one before, with the tree and leaves. And I'm noticing that the dreams are getting, the feeling gets a little bit more hopeful, I guess. Before I go on probing, I'm going to end my episode here. Thank you very much for watching. We will continue shortly. For now, bye!